Let me tell you an interesting story. A magician took a duck and placed it in water. Now the duck was a normal duck. After he placed the duck in water, he showed it to the crowd. To the surprise of the crowd, the duck appeared broken, as you can see. Now the crowd was astonished. Now what the magician did was, he took the duck out of the water and placed it on land. The crowd observed that the duck appeared whole again. It appeared normal. The magician claimed that it was due to his magic that the duck appeared broken inside water. But what do you think? Is it magic or is it physics? Let us find out. You will be surprised to learn that the duck looks like this. It looks broken inside water because of the bending of light in water. Bending of light in water. Does it hit you anywhere? We have studied that light travels in a straight line. So how are we saying that light is bending? Let us find out what is happening. Here you see there are three media: air, water, and glass. Now you can see that a ray of light is incident on the air-water interface from air. Now you see, when the ray of light hits the air-water interface, it travels inside water. But as you can see closely, it does not travel in a straight line. It bends from its original path. This happens because there is a change in medium on going from air to water. Similarly, when the ray of light is traveling through water, it hits the water glass interface. After it hits this interface, there is again a change in medium, that is water to glass. So after it hits this interface, it does not travel in its original path. Instead, it bends again. So whenever there is a change in medium, you can see that the light ray is bending. So what do you think this is called? This is known as the refraction of light. How can we define refraction of light? The refraction of light is the bending of light when light travels from one medium to another medium. As you saw in the previous case, when light traveled from air to water, there was bending of light. When it traveled from water to glass, again there was bending of light. So this bending of light from one medium to another is known as refraction of light. So let us try to demystify the case of the magician and the duck. Let us find out what actually was happening. Here, the bottom part of the duck, as you can see, is inside the water. So when the light rays from the bottom part are coming to the observer's eyes, they are first hitting the water-air interface. Now since there is a change in medium on going from water to air, the light rays that are coming out are not traveling straight. Instead, they are getting bent. It is due to this that the duck appears broken. The thing might still not be clear to you, right? Let us clarify this concept with the help of a ray diagram. In this animation, you will find that the black object represents the position of the duck. That is, when the duck has been placed inside the water, this is the bottom part of the duck. Now, as you can see, the rays of light are traveling from this to the water-air interface. Now the moment the rays of light are incident on the water-air interface, what happens? Light bends because there is a change in medium on going from water to air. These bent rays of light are then incident on the observer's eyes. Now to an observer who is seeing this from air, he is not going to be able to observe this bent path of light, this zigzag path that the light rays are taking. So the observer always has the tendency to see things in a straight line. So that is why the observer will see the light coming from a straight path. How is that happening? If we extrapolate the refracted light rays, we will find that they are meeting at a position inside water that is different from the actual position of the duck. The actual position of the duck is where the duck is actually inside the water. And the apparent position of the duck is where the observer thinks the duck is. So it is due to this that the observer who is seeing it from air thinks that the duck's bottom is broken. Now let me give you certain examples where refraction takes place. On a rainy day, after the rain stops, you must have seen a rainbow in the sky. Do you know why the rainbow formation takes place? Yes, the rainbow formation is also due to refraction. Now I have another example. On a night sky, you must have looked up at the sky and seen many stars twinkling. Now this twinkling of stars, which are millions of miles away from us, do you know what causes this? The answer again is refraction. Let me give you another example. On a very hot day, if you travel along a long road, at a distance, you will find that the road appears watery. It appears shimmery and kind of wet. Do you know why this happens? The answer to that, again, is refraction of light. So what can we say? We can say that all these situations or all these phenomena are taking place due to the refraction or bending of the light rays. So taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned that whenever light travels from one medium to another, let's say from air to water, or water to glass, or even water to air, whenever there is a change in medium, the light rays bend from their original path. They no longer continue in a straight line, instead they bend. This we saw in the case of the broken duck, which the magician claimed was magic, but now we know it was physics. We also saw certain other examples of refraction, for example, the rainbow, twinkling of stars, the wet road which we see on a very hot day. All these examples are due to refraction of light.